is your party, New Democracy, going to vote on the measures agreed between the Greek government and the creditors?
Well, first of all, let me clarify that when we talk about measures, we're really talking about two separate things. First thing has to do with the structural reforms which are included in the third program, which have been significantly delayed by the current government. We've always been in favor of important structural reforms, and if anything, we accuse the government that it is not implementing them and not assuming ownership of these reforms. The reason for that is that the creditors are requesting what we consider to be excessive fiscal measures, which go beyond the end of the current program and affect 2019-2020. We're not going to vote for those fiscal measures. We've made that very clear. We feel that these fiscal measures are the cost that Greece, unfortunately, has to pay for the incompetence of this government. But if anything, on the structural reforms, we've been advocating the government to move faster in that direction, be it liberalization or privatization or deregulation. But unfortunately, on that front, we've seen very little progress.
If the second review drags on until July, until the deadline where Greece has to repay as much as 6 billion euros in debt, and then the government asks, calls for the opposition to support the measures to avoid a Grexit, how would you react?
Look, I mean, I don't even want to contemplate that scenario. The reason being that we think that it is inconceivable that Greece will relive what it experienced during the first traumatic 6 months of 2015. I've made it very, very clear to Mr. Tsipras that he should complete the review as quickly as possible. Let me remind you that this review should have been completed a year ago. Had it been completed a year ago, nobody would be asking for additional fiscal measures. So the option that we drag on, we sort of blackmail again, hoping to find some sort of accommodating political solution, is not an acceptable option by us. Mr. Tsipras has brought us into this mess. He's been claiming that he has a solid parliamentary majority, so it's up to him to deliver. But any delay right now is at the expense of the Greek economy and will significantly undermine the possibility that Greece will achieve the estimated forecast for growth in 2017.
What if your party family in Europe, the EPP, with Angela Merkel, actually asks you to support the current measures?
We've never been asked to support this government. Again, I'm accountable to the Greek people. I've made it very, very clear that this is a bad government for Greece, that the sooner this government leaves, the better it will be for the country, and that the cost of this government remaining in power is significant for the Greek people and the Greek economy. The majority of Greeks seem to agree with this. I don't have a way to force an early election. However, I'm convinced that if it were to happen, we would win. Greece would get a better government, a much better government than it currently has, and certainly a government that would assume the true ownership of the necessary reforms to drag Greece out of this mess.
So you're still asking for snap elections?
This is a constant request for us, in the sense that, and we don't associate it with a second review. These are two sort of independent issues. For us, this is a bad government. Even if the second review is completed, Greece will drag its feet. And it will drag its feet because there is no confidence to attract foreign investment. Because we have a government that is in this peculiar situation. It has to implement a liberal reform program in which it does not believe in. So this is not a sustainable situation for Greece medium to long term.
Do you think Greece has time for snap elections?
Snap elections take 3 weeks. We've been dragging our feet for a year now. So it's not, for me, it's not not a question of timing. The fundamental issue is, do we have the government that can lead us out of this crisis? Do we have the government that can avoid, at the end of the third program, a fourth program? Because what will happen in the middle of 2018, assuming even that we complete the review? Again, let me re-emphasize that I've been asking Mr. Tsipras to complete this review for the past 9 months. So it's not that we're against the completion of the review, but we see that we're again being dragged in a situation which is certainly detrimental for the average Greek people.